Come to a funeral like that.
Come on, Miriam.
No.
Miriam, you have to.
Why are they playing that?
Body first.
What are you doing? Greg, no. Greg, no.
Thank you. the matter?
Nothing.
More coffee, Mrs. Oliver.
No, thank you, Rose.
Mr. Oliver.
Thank you. Aren't you eating?
I have to lose some weight.
You say so.
Greg?
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to talk to you.
Look, I have to check over every word in these contracts before I go into court today.
Necessary that I stay at home. Maybe I could volunteer for work at some of the hospitals.
What do you need that for?
For something to do.
What are you talking about? I thought we agreed.
I know we agreed. It's just that I feel trapped.
Trapped? What are you talking about? You can do anything you want.
As long as I stay home. As long as I have a baby right away.
That was the agreement. You have enough to do taking care of the house.
Maybe that's what the dream meant.
What dream?
The one that woke me up last night. I dreamed I was dead.
Well, that's a nice dream.
I stood beside a casket and saw myself lying inside. You told me I had to look at the body.
That's a great dream.
I think it means I'm dying inside.
Come on, Miriam. Just because I don't want you to work?
I'm sorry. I just don't think I'm ready to settle in yet. I could go back to school. Learn a profession. I'll be 30 before too long. What'll I do when the baby's grown?
It isn't even conceived yet. All this from one bad dream?
It's not just a dream, Greg. I'm talking about my life.
If you're that concerned about it, we'll talk about it tonight, all right? But right now, I gotta go to work. I'll be home by 6. What's he doing out there? I thought he's supposed to trim the hedges on Tuesdays and prune those trees on Mondays. Remember? Thank you.
Can I help you, honey?
No, thank you. I was just looking for a gift.
What sort of gift, dear?
I don't know for sure. I'll just browse.
Take your time, honey. If you need any help, I'll be right over here.
Thank you.
It's really you. You don't like it?
No.
Well, you should, dear. It'll make a new woman of you.
No, thank you.
Something else I can show you?
No.
Well, at least take the blouse, dear. I mean, do yourself a favor.
All right.
Good. It looks darling on you.
It's not for me. It's a gift.
Miss, for you, dear.
Outside chance, Curtis may be retiring, in which case I'm really next in line to be head of the firm.
At least from the standpoint of who knows the most law, of course, there's that family thing to contend with.
Marshall's only a second cousin, but it gives him an advantage.
Miriam.
Why aren't you wearing your glasses?
The doctor says I don't really need them if I don't get headaches.
Okay.
I'm thinking of going to the Slim Salon with Joni Fisher.
Mm-hmm. What's all this weight thing about, Mary?
Look at me.
You look fine. Anyway, I don't... Honey, I'm talking.
I'm sorry.
I mean, I don't see that it matters. I mean, you're going to be pregnant soon.
All we seem to talk about lately.
Miriam. I know that... Miriam, I understand how you feel. Having a baby is a big experience. I know that. We do want a family, don't we?
Yes.
We can't wait any longer. We're not children. It's not going to get any easier to wait.
I know.
Now's the time. Right? Right?
You're gonna love it. Cash or charge?
Charge. I'll take these two.
Blouse and that wig?
More than you, apparently.
Well, it isn't you.
Why?
It just isn't, that's all.
I'm 26 years old, not 40.
Well, who said you were?
My appearance says it.
It's not true.
I have a right to make myself attractive.
You are attractive.
You are smothering me, Greg.
What are you talking about?
I want to be myself.
Are you telling me not yourself?
Who are you then? Where's the address book?
In my bedside table.
Miriam? Would you come here, please?
In a moment.
Now.
You haven't stopped taking these, have you?
I don't think it's any of your business.
I was under the impression that we were planning to have a baby.
I don't have to have a baby.
Did we or did we not decide to start a family?
Do not interrogate me. I'm not on trial here. I took the pills because I'm not ready to have a child yet.
Thank you for letting me know. Sorry about last night. I'll be home at 6.
Okay.
We'll talk about it then, okay?
Yeah. Thank you, Rose. Sit down, Greg.
Mm-hmm. What's the matter?
Nothing. I found us a place at the beach.
You what?
Well, it's small, but it's really nice. It'll be a good place to go when it's hot.
You bought?
It's a rental, but it's only $290 a month, which is incredible considering how expensive those beach houses usually are. And I'm going to pay for it with my own money. I've decided that, Greg. I have the $4,000 I saved before we were married.
Miriam.
You know, it's incredible the way I found it, too. I was just driving along the coast when I saw this community. Crystal Beach. And it was like...
Miriam. Why?
Well, you know, you won't let me do volunteer work. And you won't let me, go back to school.
Well, you want to go away for weekends.
I said I'd pay for it.
I don't want you to pay for it. I don't want you to use your savings.
It's my money, and I'll use it any way I want.
Miriam, what's happening to you? You're becoming a different person.
I'll cancel the rental tomorrow morning.
Miriam?
You can look for a beach place if that's what you really want. I never thought about it, but there's no reason we can't find a cottage or something, thank you, or maybe a condominium. I mean, I don't think we're going to be very happy at Crystal Beach. But there's no reason we can't look up north for another location, maybe towards San Francisco or down towards San Diego, a lot of places. Miriam? Are you all right?
Yes. I'm fine, really. I'm sorry about the cottage. It was stupid of me.
Well, it wasn't stupid. It was just premature, perhaps.
And I'm sorry I shouted at you, Greg. But I'm not a different person. I'm still the same.
I don't follow.
I mean, I'm Miriam.
No, I know that.
I mean... I'm... still the girl you married. Still the girl you always approved of.
What are you saying?
I don't know. I mean... I mean, I love you. I need you.
I love you, too. You know that. You're my girl. My Miriam.
Yes. I am Miriam.
You know what we're going to do? Right after supper, we're going to go in the living room and we're going to light a nice big fire. And we're going to play some soft music. And we're going to sit on the sofa. We're going to talk.
Talk?
Well, we don't have to talk. I mean, we can just sit there and
We can listen to music. We haven't done that in a long time. Would you like that?
Yes, I would. Very much. Did you do that?
Do what?
You know I don't like fires.
Since when?
What? What?
Vine Wood Drive. Right. She'll be there. Thank you, Dr. Wood. Appointment set for 11 o'clock.
All right.
Why do we leave now?
I don't want you to go.
Well, I'm pretty sure I know the way.
I'm not a child, Greg. I can make it by myself.
Well, I know you can, but I want to help.
Greg, you have to be in court in San Francisco today.
I know, but they can find somebody else.
Listen. I want to go by myself, all right? I can drive myself to a doctor's office, for heaven's sakes. I'll be all right.
All right. Dr. Woodley says this guy's terrific. Look, I could always come back tonight instead of tomorrow. You call me if you need me, huh?
I will.
You promise?
I do.
You're a new girl.
Miriam, that's no name for you. Barbara? Elaine? Forget it. You devil, you. Be my guest. Ow! Fooled you, didn't I? That's what you get for following strange girls.
Thank you.
Sandy. That'll be my name. Sandy.
Time no see. How you doing?
My name isn't Sandy.
It's not. You look just like a girl used to come in here. Red blouse, blonde hair, earrings, everything.
And her name was Sandy?
Yeah. What can I do for you?
Just a glass of white wine, please. No, make that a tequila sour.
You gotta be kidding. That's what Sandy used to drink.
Make it a screwdriver then.
Okay. I don't know. She just stopped coming in. She must have moved or something. Hey, Mark! Whatever happened to Sandy?
She moved away.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Doesn't she look like her?
Yeah, she does.
Mark used to know her.
Dressed like this?
Exactly like that. What's your name?
I'm Mrs. Greg Oliver.
Where's your wedding ring, then?
I had it.
Come on, you're not married.
Yes, I am.
You're Sandy.
I've told you who I am. Well, now, will you please leave me? Now, will you kindly...
No. I want to talk to you.
Excuse me. Would you like to dance?
Thank you. I'm afraid I don't dance very well.
I'm afraid I don't believe you.
That's true. I'm sorry.
It's okay, it's okay.
If you'd rather not, I'd understand.
It's okay. Couldn't dance.
Of course I can dance.
Dance exactly like Sandy, too. It's amazing.
Thank you.
Come on, doggy. Come on, sweetheart. Come on, honey. Get out of there. Come on.
You are stubborn.
Excuse me. There's a big tan dog sitting in my car over there. Do you know who he belongs to? He just won't get out.
Yeah, that's Miss Dempsey's dog.
Dempsey?
Go up to the corner, then two blocks to the right. Can't miss it. It's a black house with a black fence.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
I guess he does live here.
Oh, he lives here, all right. Trouble is, he doesn't stay here. Keeps wandering off. Well, thank you for bringing him back.
All right. Are you Mrs. Dempsey?
No. No, Mrs. Dempsey's away. I'm just here to keep an eye on the house. And the dog. Is something wrong?
No, I was just, girl. Who is she?
I don't know. Probably Mrs. Dempsey's daughter.
Is she here?
No.
So she wasn't here when you arrived?
No, she's probably married or something. That painting does look to be a few years old. Did you know her?
No.
Thank you for bringing Henry back.
Henry?
Uh-huh. Thank you again.
Wait. Dempsey coming home.
I expect her about 7.
I'll be back. Excuse me.
Yes?
You know Mrs. Dempsey? She lives just there.
I said hello.
Do you know her daughter?
Didn't know she had one. I'm kind of new around here.
Okay, thank you.
Hey, in just a second. You know, it seems to me somebody did say something about her daughter.
Can you remember what it was?
Yeah. Somebody said she died about 5 years ago.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Somebody said she died about 5 years ago.
She died about 5 years ago.
I think I might have an idea of where she is. She's probably at the beach. Don't worry. I'll call you later. Right, thank you. Stay here by the phone. I'll call you from the beach to see if you've heard.
Yes, Mr. Oliver. Mrs. Dempsey? Oh, my. What is it? Who are you?
My name is Miriam.
Miriam? What kind of horrible joke is this?
I don't know what you're talking about. Mrs. Dempsey, I've come to see about that painting.
Get out of here.
Is that your daughter in that painting?
No, it isn't my daughter. No, that is not my daughter, Miriam. This is my daughter, and you know it.
Why are you doing this? Why are you trying to look like my daughter, Miriam?
I'm not. This is the way I look. My name is Miriam.
Mrs. Dempsey, please. Where did you get that painting?
My daughter painted it.
Of who? Who is that girl?
It's Sandy, her closest friend, Sandy Logan.
Sandy?
Sandy?
No.
It is you. Sandy, where have you been?
I'm not Sandy!
Yes, Sandy!
After all these years, you're not going to tell on me, Sandy.
I'm not Sandy!
You said you'd love me. You said you'd marry me.
I never did. I wouldn't say that.
You're not going to tell anybody what I did.
You said it. You did. You said it. I
women. You're leaving
right now.
Come on,
come on.
Oh,
Daddy, let go. Stay over there. Don't
go. As soon as you're out,
I'll get it for you.
Don't
hurt
him, Daddy.
I'll get it over you.
Threatening these horrible things.
What is it, Henry?
Oh, no. It's Mark.
We've got to stop him. Miriam, no. I'm not Miriam. I'm not. Miriam was my best friend. I'm Sandy. Miriam died because of me. And I wanted so much for her to live again that I became her. Now I can let her go. Miriam. I'm Sandy. Now I know who I am. I know who I am.